me so that he'd never go off a cork, man. You couldn't touch the Kerry man. Anyway, it's very nice to be here in public Edinburgh. I don't know how many, but it's over 50 years since the first time that we've been there. A very, very quick story about two women from Ballinicky, my own part of the world, which is a backward kind of a place. And they heard that there were shops up in Cork with no counters, and they couldn't believe it. And they made their way up to Cork and they did the checkouts. And they went up the aisles and down the aisles, and they were able to handle everything. And they went into the Harvard National Department, and one of them comes there and she knows me. She wanted the things up in the high shelves with the timber handles and the hairy tops. Another woman said, keep your voice down, get me to make you thinking easier of yourself than lavatory brushes. Well, she's done a woman, I never saw anything like them. I'd bring home a half a dozen of them. So she brought home half a dozen of the lavatory brushes anyway. And there was no sign of the family for a week after. And the local community sent the sergeant of the guards up to the house in case there was any foul deed or anything like that happen. And he went in anyway and he says to the woman, well, no one is, is it? You were in Cork. Well, that sergeant says, yeah, I was. I never saw so many houses tied onto each other. And tell me, no one is, is it? I hear he bought lavatory brushes. Oh, God, we did, sergeant. Oh, God, almighty, we bought the lavatory brushes. And tell me, no one is, is it? How are you getting on with them? Oh, says Noni, God bless them. Oh, God bless the lavatory brushes, sergeant, says she, then tear that so too, we'll come back to the paper.